Well, continuing with our Olympic coverage now, today's the 30th anniversary of the U.S. hockey team's win over the Soviet Union at the 1980 Winter Olympics in Lake Placid.
And joining us live tonight from Lake Placid with our third story is News Channel 5's Gabrielle Komorowski. Hi there, Gabby.
Hey there, you guys. Well, it is so quiet right now here inside the Herb Brooks Arena, but I want you to imagine what it must have been like 30 years ago. The American hockey players were sitting right here on this bench when Mike Ruzioni scored the winning goal and the entire arena went wild. Now, of course, most of us have heard the story. Maybe you've even seen the movie based on the story, but few of us can actually say we were inside this packed arena when the winning goal was scored. Tonight, we hear from two people who were.
He screamed in, "Do you believe in miracles?" You know, and everybody poured onto the ice. I mean, it's the most incredible thing I've ever witnessed. I mean, sitting there, we couldn't get out of here for 2 hours. The downtown and everything was so crowded with people.
At the time, I didn't even realize how incredible that was going to be. I don't think anybody recognized the significance of what it really was going to be. I just remember after the fact, and when we sort of stood back and said, "Oh my gosh, what did this, did this really happen?" It was just the most, I think, incredible experience ever, and I just will always remember it being just electric.
Well, an incredible experience for the people who are watching the game, but what about for the players on the ice? Now, here in Lake Placid, several members of the Miracle on Ice hockey team often come back here to town to meet with fans and each other. And the left wing on the team says, decades later, the whole experience is still very surreal.
Buzz Schneider has made many trips to Lake Placid over the past three decades. He's often greeted by droves of hockey fans who present him with pucks and sticks to sign. Many weren't even alive when Schneider came to Lake Placid for the first time.
30 years, it goes by pretty quick, but it brings back a lot of fond memories.
Memories of that February day when a team of college kids from all over the country became the team that would inspire the entire country.
Going into the games, we were realistically looking for probably a bronze medal. We were seated seventh. And after, you know, tying the Swedes and then beating the Czechs, we knew we were in the hunt for silver or gold.
That hunt resulted in one of the most exciting hockey games in history.
We start off the game, we were down 1-0, and I remember I scored. That was one of the highlights of my hockey career, scoring the first goal against the Russians, against Trechak, probably the best goalie in the world.
While the team of 20 players would eventually defeat the Russians on the ice, Schneider credits his team's victory to the man who stood next to the ice.
Herb Brooks, probably the best coach I've ever played for, and he's never got out-coached. He kept all of our heads regular size, and he knew what he had to do, and he worked us very hard, and he made us believe in ourselves. And we thought if we could keep the Russians close towards the end of the game, we had a chance to win. And fortunately, we did.
A victory that in many ways defined the 1980 games, when Schneider's name and 19 others forever became associated with Olympic gold.
We built a close relationship. We're still very close today, and those are the things that I remember and miss the most.
Seems like such a nice man. All right, that is it from Lake Placid for now. But you're going to want to stay with us throughout our 90-minute news block tonight. I don't want to give too much away, you guys, but I do want to tell you, myself and one of my coworkers, we're going to be heading on this magic ice in just a little bit. You don't want to miss that. See you in a little bit.